What's up? I'm Tyler Jackson. Currently, we're on Highway 156 South towards Glendale, Arizona. We're heading out for the 2013 Tostitos Fiesta Bowl between the Oregon Ducks and our Kansas State Wildcats. This is the Robert Lipson Project Part 3. Yo soy fiesta!
Our eastern states are dandies, so the people always say. From New York to St. Louis and Chicago, by the way. From the hills of Minnesota where the rippling waters fall. No changes can be taken on that Wabash cannonball. Here's to Daddy Claxton, may his name forever stand and always be remembered round the courts of Alabama. His earthly race is over and the curtains round him fall. We'll carry him home to victory on the Wabash cannonball.
So this is the crew, man. We're Glendale or bust. Got my girl Tracy here. Got my boy Drew, Charles Bartlett in the back, and then also the main man from Colorado, Mr. Jarrett Taylor. You guys ready for this?
Oh yeah.
Woo!
Oh yeah.
Like the pine trees lining the winding road, I've got a name.
Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway.
The Giants are done sitting now, the hometown of yours truly. I'm going to kick my dogs off at my parents' house. Maybe even eat some fine Mexican cuisine. That's it. Alright, you guys ready to be at Grandma's house? Alright, come on. Come on, little dogs. Yeah. How you doing, Pop?
Good. It's probably pretty crappy.
The stadium's right over here. So let's just pick up 101 and go west and just fall, stay on 101.
See now, like all the happening, like with the pep rally and stuff, so that's going to be down here. We're actually staying up in Scottsdale.
Oh,
off like 56. Yeah, we're staying in Scottsdale. That's where the Orange Tree Golf Resort's at.
Oh, okay.
So we'll be able to hop on the 101 and follow the 101 right over to the stadium.
Always wear shorts on the first day of the year.
Of course, a trip to Dodge is always complete when you go to Jalisco. So we're just now pulling into Sublette, Kansas, the hometown of the greatest Kansas State women's basketball player of all time, Shaylee Lenning. It's a little tidbit.
That's my girl.
But not one, but not two, but three rock chips hit my f***ing windshield. Look at that. That's a cracked windshield. So this is Highway 54.
Actually,
kind of like around ice road truckers, right?
Right.
Stuck in colder weather. Maybe tomorrow will be better.
17-7, 6:19 to go in the half. The Rose Bowl game on ESPN Radio.
And guy in Oklahoma, look at that. It's terrible. Damn it. Damn it. Oh, we got a nice little amount of snow all over the thing.
Boy, big rare out right there by Robert. So impressive. Watch out now. That should be a great score. 86 points for Robert.
Miles on the trip so far, about to hit Tucumcari, New Mexico. That's the end of day one. Made it to Gallup, New Mexico. 820.3 miles. Hopped on Priceline, found a nice cheap room at the Travel Lodge. We'll be back at it bright and early again tomorrow morning. Sleep tight. Good morning, back up and Adam. We are just now leaving Gallup, New Mexico, headed towards the Phoenix area, 181 miles to Flagstaff.
I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Of travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been in Opal, like a Baraboo, Waterloo, Kalamazoo, Kansas City, Sioux City, Cedar City, Dodge City, what a pity. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare man.
I'm standing on a corner in Winslow, Arizona. It's such a fine sight to see. Who's gonna save me?
Welcome to Flagstaff, Arizona. Alright guys, we're walking through downtown Flagstaff now. Looking for somewhere to eat. Any ideas, suggestions, all kinds of little cafes. How about Cafe Pickle?
A cat.
Absolutely.
Woo!
I grew the beard just for this occasion. I gotta get a lumberjack, the challenge.
You doing the challenge?
You gotta do it.
Sweet.
You got to.
Oh god. I'm gonna need 20 bucks from you up front though.
Up front, yeah, of course.
But then you'll get that.
Don't
back.
Trust me, I'm not trustworthy.
If you finish it.
Oh, he will. We believe.
So now, Anna, how many people have tried this challenge?
250.
How many people have succeeded?
Three or four.
What's the time limit on it?
20 minutes.
Wow.
Here's my question.
You up for this?
Down.
Is the sandwich itself good?
Yes.
Okay.
It's amazing.
Like if you don't finish it, it's worth the $20, right?
It's totally worth the
$20. Okay. Oh, I'm starting the timer.
I need to set the timer and take pictures.
Okay.
You have 20 minutes to eat this.
Okay.
You can start right now.
Go.
What happens if you do the lumberjack challenge twice?
Yeah, why do you think I started?
When he finishes this, he'll do another one in another 20 minutes. Boom!
You guys gonna help 4 minutes, right?
Yeah! Woo!
What's our time at it now? Right at a minute.
Done yet?
No! Oh,
so close! So close!
Look at it. Couldn't quite get the challenge finished, but he's still sitting here eating his pickle after all that. Nice job, bud. That was pretty impressive, dude.
Thanks.
How you feeling?
Man, I feel like a balloon. I feel bloated.
I bet. Just
rolling down the street.
It's on the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. Thank you.
Everything was pretty busy at the Tilted Kilt, as you could see, so we decided to go ahead and go to Scottsdale, back to our room. So Tracy and I made it back to the Orange Tree Golf Resort. Let me show you this room. This is pretty gnarly. Let me show you what we're working with here. And then there's Trey right there. Part of time. Pretty nervous for this game tonight, but I think the plan so far is I'm gonna go get some breakfast and then probably hop in the jacuzzi, get my little jacuzzi on, the jacuzzi in our bathroom, and then probably head out to the stadium, go check out the bird's nest about noon or 1 local time kickoffs tonight at 6:30. Let's go through a nice little drive through Scottsdale. What do you think? Yeah, that's no bueno. That sucks right there. That sucks, yeah. Sorry, Bubba. I bet she was texting. She had to be texting and driving. Or filming a documentary. I love Scottsdale. Like, check this out. Check that out. What up? What up? Those guys have showed up now. I did two very important things. For one, I washed my Jeep. I couldn't take it anymore. For two, we reppin'. You know we reppin'. Look at this. These flags were brand new before the season. This is their sixth state. They've fallen apart, but they repped it one more day. Oh, yeah. Do the drill. All right, babe. Blue 42. Blue 42. Down, set, hike. All right, baby. We made it. There she is. All right, what's up, Ferguson?
What's up?
You ready to do this?
Let's do what?
Do what? Are you kidding me?
Is this part of your video?
Absolutely.
Franchise.
Great. Score prediction, Ferguson. What you got tonight?
38-24.
I'm going to say the score is going to be 35-28 K-State.
Blake Pilkington right here. What's your score prediction?
35-28, Cats.
42-24,
Wildcats. Mr. Pat Morse, the greatest guy on earth. Well, Pat, what's your score prediction?
Well, I'm not sure that I'm the greatest guy on earth. My score prediction is 28-21, K-State.
There we go. My main Missouri man right here, Mr. Brett Lennon.
1,530 miles to get here, all by road.
That's dedication.
Right.
What's your score prediction?
I got the Cats at 42. Little bitty ducklings, you know, like you buy at farm stores.
Yeah, yeah.
At about 28.
This is my cousin Lauren Quinn. She's awesome. LQ, I gotta ask you though, what's your score prediction?
I predict K-State's gonna win by a lot.
Where are you guys from?
I'm from Portland.
From Portland?
Mm-hmm.
How about you?
From Eugene.
Absolutely. Nice. So how's the drive down here? Did you guys drive or fly?
The plane ride down was fabulous.
Yes, it was actually. It was very nice.
For sure.
I had three Bloody Marys.
There you go.
It was great. Girl.
That's always a nice flight. Well, I got to ask you, what's your score prediction on the game?
I think
32-24
K-State?
No.
You know what's your score prediction?
36-27
K-State. It helps that we have the best dentist on earth, Mr. Logan Morris. Logie, what's your score prediction for this game? The 2013 Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. It's big time, man. This is BCS.
It's going to be a tough matchup. I'm worried about the speed of the Ducks. I think they've got
kind of like Baylor on steroids. Almost.
A lot of athleticism on that offensive side especially. But I'm going to go out on a limb here, say Cats win 38-31.
What's your score prediction, my friend?
Do you want my purple heart or my brain prediction?
I want what you got.
My purple heart prediction is 35-17 Cats, but my brain tells me it's probably going to be opposite.
You said what? You said 35-17?
You know that.
I'm going to go with 21-17?
Cats are going to win no matter what. So whatever it is, KC's going to win.
I haven't asked you yet. I've asked everybody else. What's your score prediction for the game?
I'm going to go with 38-24 K-State Wildcats.
K-State 32 Ducks. Yeah,
17. I like that. Linda, you're from Garden City.
Yes.
No, not Garden.
Oh, yeah. Where are you from?
I'm from Dodge.
Oh, my God.
20-19.
Yes. It's going to be a close one, isn't it?
Yes.
Is that a Chris Canty jersey?
Yes.
Had a call. That's the good stuff there.
I played with him.
Yeah, right. Chilling.
My heart tells me K-State 103-7, but my head tells me 34-21 K-State.
I say Cats 40, Ducks 36.
I love it.
24-31 Cats.
I'm going to guess Wildcats 42. And, yep, that's my guess. And Ducks... 27.
Oregon's been overlooking us, kind of like Florida did last time in Louisville, so.
Yes, they did.
Kansas State 45, Oregon 24.
Score
Larry DeBater says 36-28 Cats. I don't know.
Because we're going to be found, it's going to be found flowers.
As is tradition. All right. Blue 42. Blue 42. Down, set.
Here we go, the champion of the shotgun.
Festivals kickoff, let's do this!
Yeah!
Went to 11 games this year. That's an achievement. I saw him, you know, regular season-wise, win 10 games. Saw Colin Klein, arguably the greatest quarterback of all time in school history, have an awesome season. Arthur Brown, have an awesome season. The rest of the team, I mean, I love this team, man. Friday morning, back in the car. Sad the Cats lost last night, but it was still pretty awesome. Let's just make this long drive home. Let's go. Made it back to Dodge. Dodge City, it's 4:55 in the morning. We left there like 1:30 this afternoon, yesterday afternoon. 958 miles. Drained on to Manhattan tomorrow. We're at my parents' house. So it's 3 o'clock on Saturday afternoon. Just leaving Dodge. We have to make our way back to Manhattan. It's the final leg. It's been a long trip. It's been fun. You have fun?
Ready to be home.
Definitely ready to be home.
What's up?
Back in Manhattan, 5 days, 5 states, 2,463.2 miles. That was an incredible road trip. I love Arizona. I live in New Mexico. City of Phoenix is great. City of Scottsdale is great. It was an awesome time. Didn't win the Fiesta Bowl, but you know what? We lost to a team that could have won a national championship. If it wouldn't have been for the so-called trees, they would have had a pretty good shot at it. It's a pretty good team. So nothing to hold our head about there. Got to give a shout-out to all the 29 seniors. Thanks for the memories, including but not limited to my men Colin Klein and Arthur Brown. It was an honor getting to watch you guys all these years. These last 2 years have been much more than we could have ever imagined or expected. You know, a trip to the Cotton Bowl, Big 12 Championship, a trip to the Fiesta Bowl. It was an awesome time. But I hope you have yourself an awesome offseason. Make it to the spring game. We got some great recruits coming in. Next year should be great. We'll make it through the summer. We'll have the West Stadium Center done for next fall. So Bill Snyder Family Stadium with a great team is going to be rocking yet once again. Thanks for watching the series. I'm Tyler Jackson. This is the Robert Lipson Project.
Our eastern states are dandy, so the people always say. From New York to St. Louis and Chicago, by the way. From the hills of Minnesota where the rippling waters fall. No changes can be taken on that Wabash cannonball. Here's to Daddy Claxton, may his name forever stand. And always be remembered round the courts of Alabama. His earthly race is over and the curtains round him fall. We'll carry him home to victory on the Wabash Cannonball. Listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar, as she glides along the woodland through the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engineer, that lonesome hobo's call. You're traveling through the jungles on the Wabash Cannonball.